Automating your incident reporting process using Google Forms and Portant is a great way of saving you time and standardizing your legal compliance requirements. Did you know that small and medium-sized businesses waste up to 567 hours per year on admin tasks? That's almost 3.5 months of one person's job. So, if you don't use a tool to automate your incident reporting process, you're missing out on potential efficiency gains, or even running into compliance issues. And that's why in this video, I'm going to show you how you can automate your incident reporting process in just a few minutes. Hi everyone, my name's James, and on this channel, we show you everything and anything you want to know about document automation. But in this specific video, I'm going to show you how you can automate your incident reporting process in just a few easy steps. Now, the tool we're going to use to do this is an app called Portant. Portant allows you to automate all kinds of different document processes, from contract signing to invoice creation to certificate generation and a whole bunch of others. And in this video, I'm going to show you how you can use a Google Form and Portant to automate your incident reports so that every time a form is submitted, somebody receives an email with a PDF copy of that incident report and even sign that document to confirm they had received it. So the first thing we need to do is to head on over to portant.co to sign up for a free account. I've put the link in the description below. After you've signed up, we can begin by creating a new workflow. Here you can enter a workflow name, choose an icon and a color, and then click create. Then we pick a source for the workflow. In this workflow, we're going to pick Google Forms. I've already prepared a Google Form for this, so I'm just going to pick that. Portant then shows you what the form looks like, and also on the right-hand side, it shows you all the questions in the form. You can click the Edit Form button, and that will allow you to edit the form and change questions. And then if you go back, you also have the links to respond to the form or copy it and send it to somebody. Now we just need to add the incident report template. I've also prepared a document for this, so I'm just going to pick that one. Then when it loads up, you can see all the questions from the form in the source table on the right hand side here. Some have already been added to the document, and I'll just show you how you can add a tag to the document. Just scroll down to the tag you want, click copy, then insert your cursor and click Control V or Command V if you're on a Mac. You can also change the formatting of the tag, and then the inserted data from the form will be inserted with that same formatting. Below the source table, you can also add the output name. So we can insert tags from the source table. This enables outputs from this workflow to be saved with a custom name. Finally, if we want to create this as a signable document, so we just click this big button here. And then it shows us two different tags. One is a signature tag and the other one's a date tag. Just something to remember here, when you click insert, these tags are always inserted at the end of your document. But when they've been added, you can change the location of them and move them wherever you want in your document. For instance, I'm just going to drag this one up here. And you can also add a date field, which inserts the date the user signed the document. Then after we've done that, we can go back to the workflow and we can see there's a new block here, which is called the request signature block. This block requests a signature which is sent from the email address shown at the top. The first thing to do inside this block is to identify who needs to sign the document. So we need to pick the signer's name field and also the email field from the list of questions in the form. After this, we add a subject line. In here, you can also add tags from the form. And we can also add a message here to provide a little bit more context why you're requesting this signature. After we've done that, we just click save and then go back and we've got a completed workflow. The last step is just to switch on auto create. And once we've done that, we can open up the form and we can do a test response. So I'm just going to add some test data here and then click submit. Now what Portant's going to do is generate a customized document from the answers from this form. And you can see this in the output folder here. If we open it up, you can see the document's been created and we can open up the email which is requesting the signature. This is a link to your sent folder in Gmail so you can see what the recipient would see on their end. If we click the big blue button here, we can review and sign the document and see what the user would see. Via this secure link, the user can review all the content inside the document. There's a button in the top left-hand corner where they can download it if they want. And if they scroll to the bottom, they can add their signature. Once you're happy with your signature, you just click insert, and then in the top right-hand corner, click I agree. This submits the document. The user receives a copy in their inbox. A signed copy is also sent to the person who set up the workflow. If we open up our inbox, we can see an email here that says the requested documents have been signed. So if we open up the attachment, we can scroll down to the bottom and see that it's been signed by me or the user. And then we also have the option of seeing the signed document in the Google Drive folder as well. So you can see that there's a signed copy here with exactly the same signature.
And we also have another option. If you don't need each incident report signed, you can just notify someone via email. So if we go back to the workflow, scroll to the bottom and add an email block, I'm just going to enter my email address. And then I'm also going to add in the CC box, the person who submitted the incident report. Then just add a subject line and some body copy. And then the last step is to attach a PDF to this email. And this means that anytime an incident report is submitted, that I'm going to receive an email with a PDF of that incident report to my email address.
And that's all there is to it. You've just learned how you can automate your incident reporting process using Google Forms and Portant. Now I'm curious, are you going to use the e-signing feature to confirm that people had sent or even received the reports? Or is that feature not really useful for you? Just let me know in the comments below. And if you've enjoyed this video and you want to watch more like it, teaching you document automation tips and tricks, please subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to hit the notification bell. And with that being said, thank you very much for watching. I will see you on the next video. Cheers.